Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see tender notice. So what is tender notice? See, a tender notice or tender notification is the publication and circulation by the organization in the newspapers or organization's own website and government tender bulletin. What is tender notice? It is a notification or it is a publication and circulation, means a particular organization will publicly publish something, or it will circulate a notification in the newspaper, on their own website, or in the government tender bulletin. And why they publish this? For the execution of works, for the procurement of materials, goods, services that they require on a large scale for a particular construction work. So tender notice, it is a notification and it is publication and circulation by any organization in the newspaper, on their own website, in government's bulletin. And they will publish this for the execution of work. See, a tender notice is essentially an official letter that the organization have to send for the execution of work, procurement of materials, goods, services required on a large scale. What it is saying, this statement, this sentence, the tender is an tender notice or tender is an essentially official letter. It is an official letter that organization sends for the execution of work, for supply of materials, for supply of services from a particular contractor. Thus, tenders are filled when an invitation is received for the bidding. So let me show you one of the examples or one of the format of tender notice. See, this is a format of tender notice in which heading will be there. For example, this is a e-tender, so e-tender notice. Then see, MSRDC is the body or organization who has published this tender notice. It is a e-tender notice. Name of the work, it is tolling, operation, maintenance and transfer of Rajiv Gandhi Sealing Bridge in the state of Maharashtra. So this is a standard format. You can pause the video or you can read it out. I will explain some of the points related to tender notice in the next slide. You can pause this video to see this format. Now see, this is a detailed tender notice. So you have to remember this, because the question may be asked, you have to draft the tender notice. So drafting of tender notice is a compulsory question in many exams. So you have to draft like this. See, sealed tenders are invited from the experienced consultants or contractors for the preparation of detailed project report for the following work. For example, in exam, they can ask you like this: draft a tender notice for the construction of a school building. So how you will write that? Sealed tenders are invited from experienced contractors for the construction of a school building, and it is invited by the chief engineer, MAPRDA. For example, even assistant engineer, executive engineer, any engineer you can write down here. Generally, executive engineer or chief engineer will invite this. So you can write either of them, chief engineer or executive engineer. You can change the body, MMRDA, here it is. So you can change it to PWD, WRD or any other department. Then the blank tender forms shall be issued by the executive engineer, MMRDA. Same format you have to follow. The blank tender forms will be issued by the executive engineer, and you can change this MMRDA if you want. PWD you can put here. Then location you can change as per your location. You can enter that location, or you can keep it as it is. From this to this, you can mention any dates, or you can keep it blank from date dash dash to dash dash, between dash dash hours to dash dash hours. On payment of dash dash rupees, it is non-refundable in the form of pay order, demand draft. This format is same for all of the tender notices. Then in the favor of, you have to mention the, again, if you are mentioning PWD above, you have to mention PWD here. payable at Mumbai. Sealed tender forms will be received by the assistant executive engineer, chief engineer, whatever you can write here, MMRDA, on dash dash date up to dash dash hours. In working days, you can add here. It is not added here. Will be opened on the same day if possible. And this is the table. Particulars will mention the detailed explanation about the work. For example, it is a construction of school building. So you can write it down that construction of a school building G+5 in the locality, so with area so and so, you can mention that. Estimated project cost you can mention here, earnest money you can mention here, and time limit you can mention here. So this is the tender notice format. Then what is the next? See, eligibility criteria, you can also mention this also. It will be very helpful in getting complete marks if the question asks like this for draft a tender notice. So what is the eligibility criteria? You can mention your own, but try to see this also. The firm shall have carried out at least one similar kind of work costing dash dash. So what you will mention, the contractor should have at least experience of at least one similar kind of work. You can change that also. The firm shall, you can mention contractor. The contractor shall have experience of carrying out dash dash geological studies and traffic study. You can mention that he should have experience of execution of construction work for residential as well as public buildings, for preparing the details of so and so, for drawings, preparing the detailed estimates, etc. and etc. You can mention that. Average annual financial, this is not necessary. You can mention it or you can skip that one. But format which I have shown you above, this format is very important. Up to this you have to mention. Then it is up to you whether you have to mention the eligibility criteria or not. Then the consultancy firm shall have experienced technical qualified enrolled staff. You can mention that. The contractor should have a team of experienced technical qualified staff with him in experiences related to the construction of so and so building. In our case, for example, if it is a school building, you can mention that for the construction of public buildings or mall or whatever it is. Any other requirement mentioned in the tender documents, that is, you can mention or you can skip that one. Date you have to mention, number will be kept blank, and there will be sign, executive engineer, chief engineer, whatever it is you have to mention here. So this is a standard format of tender notice. We have seen what is tender notice in the previous slides. We have seen tender notice, it is the publication or circulation by the organization in the newspaper, on their own website, or in the government bulletin. And why they publish this? For the execution of work, for the procurement of materials or supply of material to from the contractor, or goods or any service, special services may be required in the construction field. There are some structures which will need special type of construction equipment. So equipments they can want from the contractor. So all this is the standard format under which you have to write a tender notice. So this was the video on tender notice. Thank you.